Hey, in this video, we're going to see Angular signal in action. We're going to see Angular signal set, update, compute, and a lot more things. All coming after the intro. Hey everyone, this is Subrat and you are watching Fun of Heuristic. So on this channel, we'll make videos like this, which is related to programming and web development. So please consider subscribing if you haven't yet. So in our last video, we saw what is signal, why we should use signal, where we should use observable and where we should use signal, and a lot more things, how chain detection work and all. In this video, we're going to focus on how we're gonna use signal by developing a todo application. And by the way, if you haven't watched the previous video, I will link the video link on the card. You can go ahead and watch that one. In this video, I have created a todo application with the old Angular way, and we'll try to convert that to our signal way. So if we'll go to our system, here we can see that we have a simple todo application. So here you can search or add a list. Suppose I want to do some workout and I will add that. So, or some random text. So what you can do here you can search or add or delete an item. So in the code, we have a standalone component, which is todo component. So we have a form controller, we have a behavior subject, which holds all the tasks, and we have a filter task, which shows after searching the filter. So in the HTML, in the form, we have a form control, which takes our values, like when we are typing, we have a button to add, and we are running an ng for just to show the task and delete button. But if you go to the TS, first you'll go to the add task, okay? So on submit of our form, like whenever I will go and type something and hit enter, or I will hit add, here we are calling add task, okay? And in add task, what we are doing, we are just taking the value from the controller, and we are checking here that if it should not be an empty string and our task should not have that value, then we are going inside, and here we are just spreading the previous value and adding our current value to the list. And here the list means here is our subject. In our scenario, a behavior subject. And we are adding that, and we are setting again the form value to 0, means empty string. Now we'll go to our delete task. So whenever we are pressing delete, it's being deleted from our list. But how we are handling that in observable? Each we are getting the whole task from our behavior subject, splicing that task from the whole array, then emitting our next value, means emitting the behavior subject with the whole array. Now it comes to the part where we search and display something. Because whenever we are adding something, it needs to be added both in our task, which is behavior subject, and our filter task, which is an observable. Also, whenever you are searching something, then that filtered value should be filtered from our behavior subject, and it should be listed out in the HTML. So here what we are doing is we have a filter task, which is an observable of string array, because our tasks are string. And in the filter task, what we are doing, we are using combine latest from RHS, and we are combining these two values. If there is any change here, like any change in the form or any change on our value. Like suppose if I just deleted this. So this filter task need to be notified that something has been deleted and I need to run through the scan again and I need to update our value so that this thing can be rendered on our HTML. Any trigger of this will going to trigger our combine latest, and we are piping with our map operator. And inside our map operator, we are just doing a normal check, a normal string check. And that's what been displayed in the HTML. If I'll just show you again here, in our HTML, we have an ng for in with our filter task, which is an observable again. And we are running async pipe. So here we don't need to worry about unsubscribing the observable. And we are just putting the task and with the delete button. And the delete I have already explained. So as we saw, this is a very simple but effective application where we have used observable intensively and just trying to see how reactive our Angular application can be. Now we're going to see how this can be implemented with Signal. So I have created another component, which is todo Signal. So if you'll go inside that, and here, if you see, we have kind of similar but simplified option for our Signal. And I will go through one by one. For our form control, where we are getting the value, I have given the name as task string, where we are setting the value from our input field. Similarly, for the tasks, we have here as a task behavior subject. Here we have a task as a writable signal. Now here you can compare like, okay, behavior subject can act as a signal. And when you will proceed forward, you will see how signal became more sense for a lot of regions. Now the main part, which is the crucial part for this video, is our option for computed. So we have computed as well as effect, but in this video, I have used computed because it fits to this scenario. So inside computed, if you have 3, 4, n number of signals, if there is any value change in those signals, then the computed will going to execute again. And please pay attention to the word like if there is any value change. So coming back to our computed, so what we are doing inside our computed is we are grabbing all our tasks and running a filter inside it. And we are saying if our search text includes any of the task, then just assign that to our filter tasks signal. And we are accessing this filter task in our HTML. Here you can see that we are accessing our filter task signal directly like this. As you know, signal will be accessed like this and the rest all are similar. So now what will happen if there is any change with our task? So suppose we are adding some task and we are deleting some task, then the computed will be executed and it will try to filter the task. Or if there is any change in the task string, then also computed will going to be executed. Similarly, like we saw when we had our combined latest, if you have any change on this or any change on our whole array of behavior subject, then this all will going to execute. And if you see here, this is so big compared to simple signal computed. It's arguable, like if you know observable pretty well, you can think like this and you can act like this. But for a newcomer who doesn't know observable that much or doesn't want to use RxJS, for them this is a pretty good and straightforward option. And it comes with one more benefit that we need not need to unsubscribe the signal even if we are not using that in our HTML with async pipe, because it's not an observable. So the life of your signal lies with the life of your component. When the component destroys, the signal will also going to be destroyed. So while we are hitting search, we are just setting the value in the signal. That's what we need, because whenever we have any change on the task string, it will going to update the signal and it will going to render it. We need not need to do anything else. And while adding, it's kind of similar with the observable one. But what we are doing here is we are checking the similar condition here, like not empty string, so not have that value already. And then we are just updating our task signal. So in update, what we are doing is we are returning the whole array and resetting our task's value. We got all our tasks, we have spreaded it and then added our new task. And we again set this to empty string so that it will be gone from the search input box. And inside delete, we are doing the similar thing, but here we are just doing the splice and returning the whole array again. But you compare that with our observable option, it's little simple. Here in observable, what we are doing, we are getting the values from the behavior subject, splicing the value and adding the value again. And I am here trying to be an advocate of signal because this is what going to happen. But this is a slight improvement, you can say. But according to me, this computed is a huge improvement and we don't need to unsubscribe the signal. That's also a pretty huge improvement because there will be less memory leak. A newcomer need not need to know a lot of things, and that's a plus point. And now we'll go back to the HTML, and here it's quite straightforward. On form submit, we are calling add task. on our value, we are just rendering the value here. On our input change, we are calling search. That's all. If we'll go to our browser, here I have a separate route as signal to do, and here added a signal in the title, and this is the same. I'm just adding random string, and whenever I will try to delete, I can delete it. So that's how signal was. So I will just try to recap and explain it again. So in signal, what you are doing is whenever we have some input value, we are calling the search, and inside search we are setting our signal string value, which we'll use as a filter to our filter elements. And this task string is inside computed. As it inside computed, so the computer will going to trigger whenever we write something. The computed also has our tasks array. And task array is also a signal, and that we are populating with whenever we are clicking add or whenever we are hitting enter. And that task signal is also being used inside our computed. So any change of these two signal, computed will going to trigger and will return this filtered value to our filtered task. So that's all. Now you saw what is the difference with an observable, if you are trying to create an application with whole observable and with whole signal. I'm not saying that you're going to replace observable always. What I'm trying to say is, if you have a scenarios like this where you need to just write something, just need to render something, then you will going to use signal. Things like a scenario like whenever I am typing, I need to have a delay. Then I can use a delay timeout from an observable. And then that observable can be converted to a signal. Like we have a method called toSignal from observable and all. And I will make a video on how you can combine both the power of observable and the power of signal and combine them and create a great application. So stay tuned for that video, and please subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you will not miss a notification for that video, and that will going to be awesome. Because there we can see how you can make a HTTP call using debounce time, using throttle, using combine latest, using toSignal, using from observable and lots more. So please stay tuned for that. And if you are watching till now, please give a thumbs up if you like the video, so that it will motivate me to make videos like this. And please do share this video among your friends, family, colleagues. We're going to meet in the next video. Till then, stay happy. Bye-bye.